So here's another video talking about what's coming up for Extreme Rules on Raw side of things. Two things, one I do like, one I don't like. So here we go. I'm gonna start with what I don't like. Now, I think most people would agree with me on this. Okay. Yeah, there's certain situations in the way because of what's going on in the world, like what's going on in WWE, specifically with what's going on in the world, and you know what I'm talking about. So the WWE title championship match at Extreme Rules to feature Dolph Ziggler and Drew McIntyre. Now, these two were former tag team partners 2 years ago. They were tag team champions. Dolph was Intercontinental Champion at the time too. And now they're on a collision course to face each other with Extreme Rules for the championship. Oh. Booking Drew McIntyre to Dom Hill is what they're doing. Via Seth Rollins and Bobby Lashley in the last two pay-per-views. But going from those two to Ziggler, to me, seems like a downgrade. No disrespect to Ziggler, but he's not championship material. He's more of a mid-carder. He was coming off a storyline with Mandy Rose, Sonya Deville, and Otis. It doesn't warrant him a title shot at all. Any capacity. Mid-card title, he's fine with US title or Intercontinental title. I'm fine with that. But he's not top contender for any championship like the Universal title or the WWE championship. He's not in that category anymore. He was years ago, maybe. But not anymore. I know why they're doing this. Because of lack of talent right now being used. I'm going to talk about Drew McIntyre in this situation. Drew McIntyre, this just seems like a downgrade for him. This is going to be an easy win. It's going to be no, it's going to be a solid match because they could perform well with each other. But let's be honest, 100% of the people that are going to watch this know that Dolph Ziggler is not coming out as champion and Drew McIntyre is winning. But it just seems like this is a downgrade for Drew McIntyre as champion. Seth Rollins and Bobby Lashley were strong contenders. I don't know. Maybe if they had Dolph Ziggler wrestle Drew McIntyre and Money in the Bank and build up Seth Rollins and Bobby Lashley for Backlash, Extreme Rules, and perhaps SummerSlam, I'm okay with it. But now they're going in the backwards direction of Drew McIntyre, in my book. So I just hope this is not a two-man pay-per-view because it's rumored that most likely confirmed that SummerSlam is going to take place at the Performance Center, and I don't want to see Drew McIntyre versus Dolph Ziggler on SummerSlam, and I don't think anybody wants to see that. So this is not good for Judas. This just seems like a huge downgrade for him after strong competition. Like with Seth Rollins and Bobby Lashley, you know there's a chance they could beat him. Even though most people predicted Drew McIntyre to win, but at least with Seth Rollins and Bobby Lashley, they're more likely candidates to beat Drew McIntyre because they're more believable in that spot. Seth Rollins is off with Rey Mysterio, and Bobby Lashley is doing with the Bulletproofs, probably going for the United States Championship. Big news, that's big news. Is a new title, right? New design for that. So that's what I don't like about what's going on the Raw side of things. On the good side of things, I guess it changes the SmackDown a bit, a little bit of NXT. I do like a potential matchup of Sasha Banks versus Asuka at Extreme Rules for the Raw Women's Championship title. Only because I think they perform very well, they're very good wrestlers. A couple years ago, they had a good match on Raw with Asuka won. Sasha Banks and Bayley are right now at the forefront of the women's division. They're carrying the women's division all three brands. So, okay, maybe the two brands, but a little bit on the NXT brand. Sasha Banks had a great match with Io Shirai, at Great American Bash. Asuka got involved with. I know some of you might think that Bayley and Sasha are being overexposed, kind of like how people complain about Charlotte being overexposed. Right now, this situation, it's okay for them to be overexposed because Charlotte's gone, Becky Lynch is gone, that's two star of the women's divisions, and they're not using Shayna Baszler. I don't know why. There's rumors she's on main event. They're not using Bianca Belair. They're not really building up any women right now. So that's why you can see Sasha Banks and Bayley being the main women in all three brands. I guess right now back to SmackDown and Raw. I guess they're done with NXT for a little bit. Who knows? Bayley's facing Nikki Cross at Extreme Rules. I don't expect Bayley to lose there. I expect Sasha to lose Asuka. But I like this. I know they can put on a good match. And can you imagine if Sasha wins? Bayley and Sasha could have the women's title on both brands and the tag team championships. Just think of the possibilities. Just think of it. I don't think it's going to happen. I'm picking Asuka to win, right? But overall, this is what I like and I don't like. Thank you. This is, okay, after that, subscribe, like, and comment below. Thank you.